Number 7. All right, the brand new move to Body Combat 60. Like I said earlier, it's actually not a brand new move. You know, like the Esquiva, when the Esquiva came out, you get the Esquiva, and then you come here, and then you got the Esquiva. You know, like that was a brand new move. Ooh, Esquiva, or Esquiva, as Bettina says. Hey, Bettina. It's actually a cross. That's all it is. It's a cross. Your final point to the Superman punch is here, which is cross. So all you're doing is pretty much just bringing that knee up and then doing that. In the DVD, there were two ways to do it. You jump up and then you land on the front leg and that foot just kind of kicks back a little. Or I think it was Dan that did it like this. I think the Dan way would be more safe. Based on how I see my class and how they perform in my class. So in my class, I'm gonna coach it landing on both feet instead of landing on the front foot, yeah? And putting a lot of pressure there. So this is basically all you do. So lift that knee up, so a small knee forward, and then you're doing that with the back leg. That's all you're doing. It's really not much, not even that. Maybe just like that. So can you do that? Yeah, and this foot here, yeah, that's what you're doing. And landing both of them at the same time. That's all you're doing. So you strike when you land. So one, two, three lands at the same time. That's it. That's really all there is to it. It's a simple move, but it's a little bit cooler than your standard cross, yeah? Cross is my favorite punch, by the way. Love the cross, you can really get some power in there, and they've just fancied up my favorite move, so I'm loving this move. Yeah, that's all it is. Now also, you don't have to go up so high, so it's not like we come up all the way up here. It's a very low grounded move, and all it is just small steps. So again, lift that up slightly. Yeah, lift this up slightly. Put it both together. Punch at the same time. Yeah, you can bring it a little bit forward if you want. Yeah, just like that. See how I'm coming forward just like that? But on the spot is fine. So I'm going like this to propel myself forward a little. Yeah? So think of it like this. Yeah? And punch. That's really all there is to it. So just quickly as well, there's a combination in there. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah? Up, just lift that heel up off the ground and don't, as some people do. What are you looking over there? Stay in the front and just lift it up so that it can move if it wants. If it's here, that feels better. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Plant, lift, bang. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, bang. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, bang. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Track number 8, we're nearly done, team. All right, so get into right combat stance. We have double jab, rear hook. Yeah, double jab, rear hook. Double jab, rear hook. Again, pivot on the ball of your foot. Do not come up on your toes. Now, people come up on their toes, even instructors. And the reason for that is because they're moving forward and back. See how I'm coming up to the toes as I move forward and back? Yeah? Don't move forward and back during this move and try pivoting during this move. Yeah? So, double jab, hook. Double jab, hook. Double jab, hook. See how I'm coming around? And I'm not coming up on my toes. It's not good. So stop it. Pivoting gives you more ground, more power. You need to know what to aim for. If you don't have anything to aim for, then you're just guessing about. No one like me has really picked out the fine details of the move. They're just worried about the big stuff. And I genuinely, truly believe the better your technique, the better your workout. Simple as that. So if your technique is 100%, why can't you have abs? Like me. No, I'm just kidding. I haven't got that many. Ground and pivot. Don't lean forward and back. All right, now there is the uppercut sequence, which is great, I love it. Now let's get into right combat stance. 60% weight here, 40% of the weight there. So we're starting with the right uppercut. So we come around, we rotate. Now, don't be doing your uppercuts from up here. Yay, I'm doing body combat, yay! Yeah, no. Let's work on our technique. So, lean over, because you're supposed to get underneath this uppercut. This power now, you're generating so much power by being here. All these muscles are now engaged, ready to fire an uppercut straight under someone's jaw, as opposed to here, like, you're already upright, you're not doing anything. You're not here loading and exploding, you know, under the jaw. So what you need to do is bend those knees, give yourself a twist, twist that shoulder, twist your spine, and unwind, bang. Hide that shoulder, show that shoulder, yeah? So leaning over will help you twist and work more core instead of like here. Like, you're not really doing anything. You need to put yourself under pressure and rotate there. So here is where you can go for your level two, I suppose. Level one, fine. Back heel up and stay up here and rotate there. At least you're at body combat, and at least you're in the gym, you know, doing a workout. So this would be level one here, but challenge yourself and lean over, go to level two, right here. Lean over, twist. This is what my body looks like without the punches. And that's what I say in class, so that they can visualize and not get distracted by the arms. So I say, this is what my body looks like. Yeah, now add the arms. Or arm. Yeah, so rotate. You want more power, bend the knees. Bang, bang, bang. Twist this way now, bend the knees, rotate, hide that shoulder, show that shoulder, hide, show. Bang, 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 bang. Level one, up here. Level two, lean over, twist. Level three, use your knees. Bend them, use your legs, explode up. Now also in this track, there is a good opportunity just to go, like give you that explosive white muscle fiber workout by stepping forward and back, yeah? Getting into the fighting zone and stepping out into the safe zone. So fighting, safe. So when you're in the fighting zone, what you wanna do is smack out two really quick and then get out again, yeah? Bang, bang, and then out. Bang, bang, out. Bang, bang, out. And then blasting out two jabs. Wah, and then get out before they retaliate. Yeah? So do it, yeah? Don't just, I'm doing body combat. Yay. Yeah? Exhale as you do it. All right, team, track number nine. With the push-ups that we do, I've never covered this before, and I'm gonna cover it now. I'm gonna show you now how to position your hands so that you can do your perfect push-up, wide grip and close grip. Instructors would say shoulder width, or a little bit wider than shoulder width, or a little bit closer, depending on what the instructor feels on a day. That can be very incorrect, and I'll explain why. when you do a push-up, now have a look here. If I go shoulder width, which is about here, and I'm doing a push-up to work chest, yeah? So my elbows are of course gonna be going out so that I can work chest. Now, if I go shoulder width, which is about here, and go out, have a look at how much pressure is in the wrist here. Look how much that's kind of, twisting on the right side. So I would ideally need to go here so that when I do a push-up, there's not that much pressure as opposed to here. You see that business? Okay? So that's something that you need to consider. If I was to go too wide out, then there would be a lot of pressure here on this side. You see that business? And also when I get up, have a look at that. See that pressure there? So on the up, there's a lot of pressure there. Too closer in, on the down, there's a lot of pressure there. So you need to find the center point of where there is no pressure on this side and there is no pressure on that side. So my distance is probably about here. Also, there needs to be a certain twist of your wrist or your hand, you know, to kind of fix a little bit of pressure on either side. Now, there's always going to be a little bit of pressure on one side and a little bit of pressure on the other side. There's always going to be that. So to find the exact center of equal pressure on both sides, it would be a simple twist out or a twist in. Most likely twist out. So if you position your hands straight, so it'd be a slight twist out, and that should be the perfect push-up position for you. Yeah? So if I go down now, there's no real pressure on the outside. Does that make sense? And if I go up, there's no real pressure on the inside. So that would be my perfect, maybe a little bit more out I need to go. Yeah? Now for close grip push-up, people say hands together and hands out. But have a look at the pressure there. See that? It's pretty much the same as doing, you know, these ones. To have the perfect close grip push-up would be shoulder width apart. So like this, and you would literally go down like that. Let's do it from the side. Bring the elbows straight down to the floor and parallel to your body. That's how you have this part of your arm, so parallel to your body. So don't have it out. You'll probably find that's why you can't do them, because it's so awkward very dangerous on your wrist. So yeah, you want it shoulder width apart, and you want your elbow going down in the same direction as your body. So that's how you would do it. So like this, and straight up. So if you have a look, there's no pressure on my wrist. Yeah? So maybe slightly out is what I'd need. Yeah, I reckon slightly out. So shoulder width and slightly out is what you need for close grip push-ups to work your triceps as a primary muscle and then chest as a secondary muscle. So if you want to flip that around, go wide to use your chest as a primary and your triceps as a secondary. So that's a chest, as in a push-up, a proper push-up to work your chest. So wider than your shoulders and slightly out, and that's perfect for me. You need to find what's perfect for you. That's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks for all the support that you guys have been giving me, you know, throughout the years of making these videos, presented to you by yours truly, Tommy Damani. Don't forget to check out my brand new website, boxingworkoutideas.com. Spread the love, chuck it on your Facebook page, tell your friends about it, tell your local gyms about it as well. They could spread the news to their coaches and instructors. Thank you very much for liking the page on the Body Combat Tutorial Team Facebook page. Thank you guys, I love you, I love your support, and I'll see you next time.